Hello everybody, today we are going to see some more problems which are depend on the concept quadrilateral. Okay, now we have seen some problems depend on the special quadrilateral, that is parallelogram. Okay, today also we will see some more problems depend on the same concept. Okay, so here first problem is PQRS is a parallelogram. PX and QI are respectively the perpendiculars from P and Q to SR and RS produced. Prove that PX is equal to QI. Okay. So see here once again, PQRS is a parallelogram. PQRS, figure is given. PQRS is a parallelogram. Then second thing they have given us, PX and QI are respectively the perpendiculars from P and Q. PX is perpendicular and QY, here Y. QY is perpendicular from point P and Q. Okay. SR and RS is produced. SR is produced till Y. SR and RS. RS is produced. Okay. So now there are in this means the base is same here. This is parallelogram and there are two triangles, this one and this one. Okay, triangle SXP and triangle RYQ. Two triangles are there and finally they are asking PX is equal to QI. PX this side and QI are equal. That we have to show. Then we can understand very easily. If we are able to prove this triangle SXP and triangle RYQ are congruent, then easily we can say PX and QI are same. Okay, so if we will think about these both triangles, then one thing we have, that is this is a parallelogram. They have told us PQRS is a parallelogram. So we can say PS and QR are equal because opposite sides of parallelogram. So that one thing we have. Second thing, angle SXP, it is 90 degree, also RYQ is also 90 degree. Okay, so this angle 90 degree and that is 90 degree. Okay, so two things we have, one angle and one side. Okay, one pair of side. One more thing we need, that we need to find out from these two triangles. Okay, so we will mention here first thing, that is PQRS is a parallelogram. PQRS is a parallelogram. Then PS is equal to QR. PS is equal to QR. Okay. Now one thing we know, that the adjacent sides of parallelogram are supplementary. So here about PQRS we can say this angle PSR plus angle QRS is equal to 180. I am talking about this angle 1 and this angle. Okay, so that I am taking here angle PSR plus angle QRS. Angle QRS is equal to 180. PSR plus QRS is equal to 180. So this is from this we can say, suppose I want to find out angle PSR. Angle PSR is equal to 180 minus angle QRS. 180 minus QRS. PSR is equal to 180 minus QRS. Okay. Now this I will say this is first one. Okay. Now we will think about this. Angle 2 and angle QRS is equal to 180 degree because they are forming linear pair. Okay. So now QRS, angle QRS plus QRS plus 2. I am saying directly here, or we can write QR1. Instead of that, we can take angle 2. Angle 2 is equal to QRS plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So angle 2 is equal to what? Angle 2 is equal to 180 minus angle QRS. Angle 2 is equal to 180 minus QRS. Angle PSR. Angle PSR means what? Angle 1. This is PSR means what? Angle 1. So that we can mention here. Angle 1. Angle 1 is equal to 180 minus angle QRS. And angle 2 is equal to also 180 minus angle QRS. So from 1 and 2 we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Angle 1 and angle 2 are same. So this is our third thing. Okay, so here we can say from first and second. First and second. Got it, everybody? Why both angles are same? PSR. PSR means what? Angle 1. Angle 1 is equal to 180 minus QRS. Okay, and angle 2 is equal to 180 minus QRS, means this value and this value is same. RHS are equal, so definitely its LHS are also equal. So angle 1 and angle 2 are same. Okay, now we need to use, this is the third thing. Okay, so now we will think about in triangle SXP and triangle RYQ. We have two things, that is PS is equal to, for first we will take this angle SXP is equal to angle RYQ, angle RYQ. Why, what is the reason? Both 90 degree. Okay, this is first thing we have, angle. Second thing, just now we told here angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So that I am going to mention directly here, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Okay, from third, angle 1 and angle 2. Angle and side PS is equal to QR. Okay, PS is equal to QR, that is, what is the reason? Opposite side of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are always equal. So we have two angles and one side. Two angles and one side. So with the help of this, we can say triangle SXP congruent triangle RYQ. SXP congruent triangle RYQ. Okay. If triangles, here we need to write by angle side. This is important. Okay, angle side, both the triangles are congruent and they are asking PX and QI. PX and QI are equal. PX is equal to QI. Why? By CPCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so this was very simple proof. See carefully and solve this in your notebook. Okay, see here, our next problem is, in figure, ABCD is a parallelogram and angle DAB is equal to 60 degree. If the bisectors AP and BP of angles A and B respectively meet at P on CD, prove that P is the midpoint of CD. Okay, figure is given. Once again see, in figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. Here figure is given. ABCD is a parallelogram. Angle DAB is equal to 60 degree. Okay. If the bisectors AP and BP of angles, AP is the bisector of angle A and BP is the bisector of angle B. So this angle here, it is given DAB is equal to 60 degree and that angle is divided into two equal parts, 30-30 degree. Okay. And if the bisectors of AP and BP of angles A and B respectively meet at P, bisectors meet at P on CD, prove that P is the midpoint of CD. We have to prove P is the midpoint, means actually we need to show CP is equal to DP. That is our target, that we have to show. Okay, as this is a parallelogram, then we can say easily angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so according to that, we will take first ABCD, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. So angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Angle DAB, angle AB is what? Angle DAB is given 60 degree. So 60 degree plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. So angle B is equal to 180 degree minus 60 degree. So angle B is equal to 120 degree. Angle B is equal to 120 degree. Okay. Angle B 120 degree. So now here 120 degree will divide into two equal parts, that is PBA and PBC, means this will be 60 degree and this is 60. Okay, because PB is the bisector of angle B and here AP is the bisector of angle A. Okay, so angle B is 120 degree. In that PBA, so PBA is equal to PBC, angle PBC is equal to 60 degree each. Okay, because BP is the bisector, of angle B. Okay, so now if you will see here, CD and AB are parallel to each other. Okay, both sides of parallelograms are parallel to each other, and here AP and PB both are the transversal. So first we will use CD and AB. When CD and AB are parallel, CD is parallel to AB. CD is parallel to AB. That time AP is the transversal. AP is the transversal. AP is the transversal. Okay. So we can say angle PAB is equal to angle APD. APD. Why? Alternate interior angle. This angle will be equal to this. Two lines are parallel and AP is the transversal. So alternate interior angles are equal. So we can see here angle DPA. Angle DPA. DPA is equal to PAB. Angle PAB is equal to 30 degree. This we will see first. Okay, so this is 30 degree and this is 30 degree. So we can say triangle ADP is an isosceles triangle. Triangle ADP is isosceles triangle. Okay, this is 30 degree, this is 30 degree. Okay, so finally we can say from this we can say DP is equal to DA. DP and DA are equal. Okay, why? Opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Okay, so this is first thing we got. Okay, DP and DA are equal. Okay, now we will think about this PB. Okay, again CD is parallel to AB and PB is a transversal. PB is a transversal. Okay, in that case also we can see the same thing. PBA angle PBA is equal to PBC angle PBC is equal to 60 degree. Okay, this is and this two are alternate interior angles. Alternate reason will be alternate interior angles. Okay, so this angle is 60 degree and this is 60 degree. Base angles are same. So angles opposite of equal sides are same. So we can say from this BC and PC. BC is equal to PC. BC and PC are equal. Angles opposite of equal sides. Sides opposite of equal angle. Sides opposite of equal angles are equal angles are always same. Okay, so both angles are 60 degrees. So we can say PC and PB are equal. Okay, so this I am saying this is second one. Okay, this I am saying this is third one. This will be this is third one. Okay, now BC is equal to PC, but ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. So we can say AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to BC because ABCD is parallelogram and opposite sides of parallelogram are always equal. AD is equal to BC. But here we got AD is equal to DP. AD is equal to DP. Okay. And here BC is equal to PC. Okay. So AD, at the place of AD, we will replace DP. and BC, at the place of BC we will replace PC. DP means this distance and PC means this distance. Both the distance are equal. That means P is the midpoint. So here we will say from second and third. Okay. DP is equal to PC. DP and PC are same. This distance and this is equal. So we can say P is the midpoint. Midpoint of DC. P is the midpoint of DC. According to the question, P is the midpoint of DC or CD. Okay. Okay, see here, our third problem is, if ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is parallel to CD and AD is equal to BC, prove that angle A and is equal to angle B. Okay, here quadrilateral is given. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is parallel to CD. Okay, and AD is equal to BC, that is given. AD and BC are equal. Prove that angle A is equal to angle B. Angle A and angle B are equal. That we have to show. Okay, so now this is a trapezium. Okay, so here directly we cannot prove that angle A is equal to angle B. Okay, we can convert this figure with the help of construction. We can convert this figure into parallel. Okay, so if we will take AD, a parallel for AD from point C, and we will extend this AB. Okay, suppose here we will give E. This is angle E. Now AD is equal to CE. DCEA is a parallelogram. Okay, so first we will mention here construction. Okay, construct CE parallel to AD. CE parallel to AD. Okay, CE and AD are parallel to each other. That means we have the construction. So we can say quadrilateral ADCE is a parallelogram. ADCE is a parallelogram. Okay, so here AD is equal to CE. AD is equal to CE. Okay, because opposite sides of parallelogram. So that we can mention AD is equal to CE. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Okay, AD and CE are equal. Next thing, now if you see here, we can write angle A plus angle E. Angle A plus angle E are adjacent angles of parallelogram. So adjacent angles of parallelogram are always supplementary. So we can take that angle A plus angle E is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so here from this we can say angle A is equal to 180 degree minus angle E. So that I am saying here first one. 180 degree minus angle E. Okay, so this is our first one. Now if we are going to think about triangle BCE, AD is equal to EC. AD and EC are equal. But it is given that AD and BC are equal. Okay, what is given? AD is equal to BC. Okay, that is given thing. But AD is equal to EC. That is by construction. Accordingly, we have done construction. Okay, AD is equal to EC. So we can say from these two, we can say BC is equal to CE. BC is equal to CE. So this I am saying second and this is third one. Okay. So from second and third, we can say BC is equal to EC. From second and third. Okay. BC and EC are equal. Okay. So this is an isosceles triangle. Triangle BCE is an isosceles triangle. If these two sides are equal, angles opposite of equal sides are always same. So that we can write here. Angle CBE is equal to angle CEB. Angle CEB. CBE means this angle and this angle is equal. Okay, so if I want to replace this angle CBE, CBE is equal to which angle? What we can write? 180 degree minus CBA, CBA or angle B. Angle B why? Because we are thinking about this quadrilateral which is given. Constructions we have done afterwards. Okay, so this, if I want to replace this angle CBE that I am taking now here, angle CBE, I want to replace this angle, then how we can write? 180 degree minus angle CBA or angle ABC is equal to CEB. CEB is what? Angle E. Okay, so now here we can take 180 degree minus angle ABC, we can write angle B is equal to angle E. Angle E. Okay, so here if I will say this angle B here, see here, we are going to bring this 180 degree, this angle E will come this side, minus angle E is equal to angle, angle B will move that side, plus B. Now if you observe here, we got in first, we got 180 degree minus angle E. Here also we have 180 degree minus angle E. Okay, so this is, I am saying here, fourth one. Okay, and here this is first one. So from first, RHS are equal. From first and fourth we can say, if RHS are equal, its LHS are equal. Okay, so from 1 and 4 we can say angle A is equal to angle B. Angle A is equal to angle B. Okay, and that would be, they are asking to prove angle A is equal to angle B. Why? What did everybody? Because the value of angle A is equal to 180 degree minus angle B, and the value of angle B also 180 degree minus angle B. Okay, so the RHS are equal, or one side of both the equations are equal, so we can say angle A is equal to angle B. Okay, thank you very much.